Who will do, tiddly peeps? I'm Hubba Hubba, talking to you from Hoobland, and I'm about to send four of my favorite Hoobs down to Earth to find out all about you for my great Hoobopedia. Here they come! You know who the Hoobs are? Things we want to know. Holla, hollas in Hoobland, and roam us somewhere far away. The motorettes are singing.
We keep the engine spinning.
Hoob, hoob, hooray! The Hoobmobile is coming your way.
Doop, little Hooby plants. And how are you all this morning? Oh, dear. You don't look very hoobly groobly at all. Oh, no, no, don't droop.
Oh, what's the matter, Tula?
Oh, Hoobadoop Groove, for some reason, the Hooby plants are not looking at all hoobly groobly. Oh, they're drooping.
So they are. But look, there must be something we can do to cheer them up.
Yes, but what?
What?
Oh, Groove, this was a hoobacious idea of yours. I'm sure they'll stop drooping now they're down here inside with us.
Yeah, I'll go up to the roof and get some more, shall I?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, sorry, Ivor.
Groove, where are you going?
Upstairs. Where did all these hooby plants suddenly come from?
Upstairs.
Tula, what are all the hooby roof garden plants doing down here in the Hoobmobile?
Well, Groove and I were just thinking that perhaps being with us for a while might cheer them all up. Besides, having them inside makes the Hoobmobile feel more homely, don't you think?
Well, yes, but I don't think...
Where do you want this one, Tula?
No idea. You choose, Groove.
Oh, right, OK. Excuse me, Ivor.
What?
There.
Groove, do be careful,
place,
please.
Let's try over just here. Sorry, Ivor.
Groove, will you hurry up? We need to find a question for Hoob News.
I can't decide.
I've just been telling the Hoobie plants how lucky they are.
In what way?
To have the Hoobmobile as our home. Could you find a place for this, Ivor?
And again, this? Me? Yes. Well, you're right, Tula, we are lucky. But I'm not sure we really want to clutter up the Hoobmobile with hooby plants.
I mean, what other creature on land lives in a home that it can take with it?
What other creature on land lives in a home that it can take with it? Now that's what I call a hoobble-dooble-dooper question for my Hoobopedia. Just the sort of thing Hoobs everywhere will want to know.
I think so too, Hubba Hubba.
Good. And I hope Ivor and Groove agree, wherever they are.
We're here, Hubba Hubba!
Oh! Hoobie-galoobie, so you are! I thought you were a hoobo cacto spiker, Ivor. I'll tell you what. Let me have a look on Hoobnet to see if I can find anything about homes to get you started. La! Take a look at this. Oh, there's some birds in a home in the grass. Oh, look, there's Spider making his home. These creatures seem to be taking things to their homes, but not taking their homes with them. There's a horse pulling a home behind it.
Well, there were hoobloads of different homes there, weren't there?
Yeah, but you couldn't move about in them like we do in the Hoobmobile.
Wait a minute. There was one home we saw that did move, didn't it?
The one belonging to the horse.
Yes.
So maybe the horse takes his home with him like we Hoobs do.
Yeah, Hooby Groovy idea, Tula.
I know. Let's ask Hubba Hubba if we can print out a picture of that horse and his house.
Hubba! Hubba! Hubba!
Hubba.
Hubba Hubba, could we print a picture of the horse's house that you found on Hoobnet?
Of course you can, Tula. Let me see now. Here it is.
Oh, that's Hoobie Groovy, Hubba Hubba. I'll print that out.
I'm not sure that that horse would actually fit inside that house.
Well, someone will know the answer to it.
Yes, they will. But who?
Why, the Tiddly Peeps, of course. Well, they're bound to know if that's the horse's very own little house. The Tiddly Peeps know everything.
Hubba Hubba, you are absolutely right.
Yeah.
Why, thank you, Ivor.
I'll take the picture to the Tiddly Peeps.
And I'll drive.
And I'll talk to my Hoobie plants to see if it makes them feel any more hoobly groobly.
Okay. Right. I'm off to see. Perhaps, Tula, you'd like to take them back upstairs and talk to them there. Seatbelts?
Yeah. We're off to see the Tiddly Peeps!
We're off to see the Tiddly Peeps, on the road we go. We're off to see the Tiddly Peeps,
they're smart,
they're fun,
they know.
The Tiddly Peeps, if we need to know. Who, what, where, why, when, and how, we'll ask them, off we go.
When the weather gets nice, we can take it out.
Oh! Hello!
Hello!
Hi, Papa!
Oh. Hello, Aisha! Oh, hello, Emma! How about doing me a hoobacious hoobie hello?
Okay. Yes! Who will it? Who will it? Woot, woot, woot!
Fantastic! Now, I need your help. Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Does a horse live in this little home?
Nope.
Are you sure?
No.
Yes, Ivor, I'm absolutely positive. The horse pulls it along.
But why would he just pull it along?
Peeps travel inside it whilst the horse pulls it.
How hoobacious is that? Would you know of another sort of home that you can take anywhere with you?
Yes. This one.
Is that a little home that you can take around with you?
Yes, it's a tent. You can take it with you anywhere.
Tula! Groove, look at this. Ask Hubba Hubba to send us a tent off Hoobnet.
A tent.
I think we've got the answer.
Tent.
Thank you so much, Tiddly Peeps. I'll have my picture. Thank you. Thank you, Aisha. Thank you, Emma. And thank you, Megan. Hoople toodle do.
Hoople toodle do.
Come on, plant.
The tent has arrived from Hubba. Hubba. Oh, that's.
Mind the plants, Groove.
Has it arrived? Has our tent... Oh, Tula, I really would rather you put the Hoobie plants back upstairs.
Well, sorry, Ivor, I will. It's just that having them down here somehow reminds me so much of home. I'll move them back up just as soon as we've tested out our tent.
Hmm? Oh, yes. Well, the one the Tiddly Peeps had didn't look anything like that.
Yeah, are you sure this is definitely a home that a creature can take with it?
There must be some way we can make it look like the one the Tiddly Peeps had.
Yes, but how?
How, how, how. How, how, how. How, 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 how.
Here's how. Ta-da! One tent.
Oh, Groove, that's who. Hoobacious!
I should say it is.
But can you move about with it, Tula? I mean, is it like the Hoobmobile? Will it travel?
There's only one way to find out.
There's only one way to find out.
No!
Oh, Hoobie bother.
Hoobie blow? Look at my poor Hoobie plants!
Tula! Never mind the Hoobie plants. At this rate, we're not going to answer the question in time for Hoob News.
Hubba. Hoobledoop Hoobs. How did the tent go down?
With a crash, Hubba Hubba.
Sorry.
It's definitely not a home you can travel around in like a Hoobmobile.
No, it's the sort of home that you take with you and put up when you get to, well, wherever you're going.
Except we didn't manage to put it up very well.
Hoobie Galooby, is that giant plant actually talking?
No, Hubba Hubba, it's me.
So it is, Tula. Oh, come on, cheer up, Hoobs. Perhaps it will help if you have a little look at a story I found on Hoobnet. This just might help you to answer the question. Hold on. Here it comes.
Darren, a very small hermit crab, looked around his rock pool and sighed. Every day, Darren was stuck with the same boring old starfish, the same moaning anemone. I'm bored with living in the same old rock pool day after day, said Darren. I really wish that I had a home that I could take with me. Then every day I could ramble around all over the seabed and never get bored. Darren bumped into a jellyfish. I'm looking for a new place to live, he said.
How about living inside a witch's purse?
She pointed to a witch's purse and Darren wriggled his way inside it. But what he didn't know was that a witch's purse is where a fish called a skate lays all her eggs. And when Mrs. Skate returned, she was not at all amused at finding Darren crouched in there too.
Get out, you horrid little crab, she cried.
Then, just as Darren thought he'd never find a home he could take with him, he spotted just the thing. It was an old tin can on the sea floor. He could easily fit inside that. He could even roll around inside it.
I don't want to live anywhere else, he said. My new roly-poly tin house is fantastic. I can roll around in it all day, all over the seabed. And best of all, no one knows I'm inside it till I stick my head out and go boom!
That's it! At last we've got the answer. A hermit crab lives in a home which he can take around with him.
Hoob, 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 hooray!
Hoobs travel round in our Hoobmobile. We take it wherever we go.
But we've been finding out if there's anyone else about who takes their house around with them. We really need to know.
At first we thought a horse could be the answer.
A tent seemed like a good idea as well.
We put one up in here, but it soon became quite clear that it wasn't what we wanted. Down it fell.
Found you all a lovely story. A hermit crab had come up with a plan. He wanted a new home in which he could be alone, and he found one in an old tin can.
Roly-poly little hermit crab, making a terrible din. You've cleared up our confusion and provided a solution. A hermit crab lives in a rusty tin. Roly-poly little hermit crab, making a terrible din. You've cleared up our confusion and provided a solution. A hermit crab lives in a rusty tin. Yes, a hermit crab lives in a rusty tin.
So, there we are. We're all ready for Hoob News.
We are?
Of course we are, Groove. Hermit crabs live in tins.
Well, there are no hermit crabs living in this tin.
No?
No, just Hoobie Beans.
Oh, Hoobie Beans. Well, they won't be living in it for long. Thank you.
I'm not sure that the hermit crab is the answer, Ivor.
What do you mean? A tin can is his home and he takes it around with him.
But the crab kept changing homes, didn't he?
Sorry?
He didn't stay in the same home all the time.
I can't understand a word you're saying, Groove.
I think he said that the crab didn't stay in the same home all the time. You know, like we do.
Yeah, that's exactly what I said.
The crab kept changing homes.
Oh, I see. Oh, yes, you're right. Who'd be bother? Will we ever get the answer to this question? Tula, these hooby plants...
Oh, sorry, Ivor, but the more you keep knocking them over, the more droopy they get, and the more droopy they get, the longer they need to stay down here so I can cheer them up.
Oh, we must be able to find some other creature on land, apart from us, who lives in a home they take around with them.
Yes, but where?
Where? Roma.
Oh, hey, here comes Roma. Maybe she knows where we can look for the answer.
Hmm, I do hope so.
Hoobledoop Hoobs. Hubba Hubba's asked me to find out all about homes. And I've come here to the bottom of a very deep blue sea. As you can see, this is home to hoob loads of different creatures. But so far, I haven't found any sort of home that a creature takes with it. In fact, the only thing I've found, Hoobs, is this. I'm told that this is something called a clamshell. Who knows? Maybe something called a clam lives in there. If that's true, then this shell would be its home.
Ooh.
Though I have to say, this particular home would definitely not be to my taste. Not Hoobacious at all. Far too dark and a bit smelly. Wait a minute, Hoobs. Hoobie galooby, there really is something living in there. Well, it's extremely soft and rather slimy. Yeah. Probably not the kind of thing that could really leave its shell very safely.
So that means the clam would have to take its home with it, Roma.
Well, I suppose you're right, Tula. How about that, Hoobs? Some creatures live in the strangest places. This is Roma Hoob, at home with a clam. Ha! Ah, Hoobledoodle-doo!
So, now at last we know another creature who takes his home with it...
Like Hoobs do, is called...
A clam. Oh, sorry.
A clam.
Yes, a clam, that's it. We've found the answer.
Oh, hey, would you like some hooby beans to celebrate?
Don't mind if I do, Groove.
Oh, no, wait, Ivor, Groove.
What's the matter, Tula?
Sorry to spoil your hoopy bean feast, but I just had a thought. The question was, what creature on land lives in a home that it can take with it?
Yes, and it's a clam.
Yes, but listen. The clam we just saw, well, it doesn't live on land, does it?
No, it doesn't live on land.
It lives under the sea.
Under the sea? Oh, no, you're right, Groove. A clam lives under the sea. Oh, no, what are we going to do?
Calm down, Ivor.
Hubba.
Hoobledoop Hoobs.
Hoobledoop Hubba.
Have you found the answer, Hubba?
Well, I'm sorry, I haven't, I'm afraid.
Oh.
But I do have one more suggestion.
What? Yes?
Yes, can you think of a really clever tiddly-peep who might know the answer?
Oh, well, there are so many clever tiddly-peeps to choose from.
Yeah, how about Harry? Yeah, because our friend Harry would know. Yeah, let's go and find him.
Shall I email him and let him know we're on our way, Ivor?
Good idea, Tula.
And I'll drive.
We're off to see the tiddly-peeps, on the road we go. We're off to see the tiddly-peeps,
they're smart,
they're fun,
they know.
The tiddly-peeps, if we need to know. Who, what, where, why, when, and how, we'll ask them, off we go.
Oh!
Yoo-hoo!
We're off to see the tiddly-peeps, on the road we go. We're off to see the tiddly-peeps, they're smart, they're fun, they know.
I wonder where Harry is. He's
behind
said
you.
Me here. Oh, Tula, Groove, here he is. And I wonder what he's looking at.
Hoobledoop, Ivor.
Hoobledoop.
Come and see what I found.
Oh, don't tell me. I hope it's something utterly, superbly hoobacious. It's
yes.
If that isn't the funniest looking thing I've ever seen in my entire hoobie life.
It's called a snail.
A snail?
Yes, and see its shell.
Can you
see this groove?
Yeah.
It's its little home that it takes everywhere with it.
Of it? What do you know? Hoobie galooby! It takes its shell everywhere it goes.
Yes.
What, it carries its little house with it all the time?
That's right.
Do you know, you have just found the answer we've been looking for all day.
Yeah.
A hoobble dooble dooper. I must get back to the Hoobmobile. We've got a Hoob news to do. Hoobble toodle doo.
Hoobble toodle doo.
Thank you.
Oh, so now we know.
Yeah, Harry's a really hooby groovy tiddly peep, isn't he, Tula?
Did you see? Did you see that groove? There really is another creature that travels around inside his house like Hoobs do.
Ah.
And maybe after Hoob News, Tula, we can move all the Hooby plants back up to the roof garden.
Maybe we can, Ivor. I think that the Hooby roof garden really is their favourite home.
Oh, come on, then. Into the Hooby studio.
Slippery snail, moving so slow, leaving a slimy trail as you go.
Slither along, quiet as a mouse, carrying with you your own special house.
Slippery snail, moving so slow, leaving a slimy trail as you go.
We stay indoors, no need to roam, this is our very own mobile home.
Slippery, slithery, slippery, slithery, slippery, slithery trail. Slippery, slithery, slippery, slithery, slippery, slithery snail.
Hubba. Well, Hoobs, are you ready with your news for my Hoobopedia?
We're ready, Hubba Hubba.
Well, take it away.
Hoople doop whoop to all you Hoobs out there. Welcome to Hoob News, the new show for Hoobs everywhere. I'm Ivor.
I'm Tula.
And I'm Groove.
And today we've been asking the question...
What other creature on land lives in a home that it can take with it?
First we looked at lots of animal homes.
And we thought that perhaps a horse lived in a house on wheels like ours.
That turned out to be a Hooby boo-boo. Sure, but the Tiddlypeeps did have a little home that you can take around with you called a tent.
And after Hubba Hubba ordered one for us, we tested it out to see if you could travel around in it.
And we found out that you couldn't.
Then Hubba Hubba found us a story which he thought might help. But that was all about living inside a tin can.
I looked inside one of our tin cans and found that only Hooby Beans lived there.
Which was really good to know.
But it didn't help us answer the question.
Then Roma found us a creature called a clam that carried its own home around with it everywhere.
But unfortunately, clams only live underwater, not on land.
Then, just as we thought we'd never find the answer, Hubba Hubba suggested we found a tiddlypeep to ask.
So Ivor went to visit our friend Harry, and he had the answer. There is another creature on land who lives in a home he can take with him, and he's called...
A snail!
A snail! How hooble-dooble-dooper! So it's thanks once again to Ivor, Tula, Groove and Roma for giving Hoobs everywhere a little peep into the world of peeps. And remember, wherever your home may be, have a nice day and hooble-toodle-doo!
Hooble-toodle-doo!
Right, let's get these Hooby plants back upstairs to the roof garden. Groove!
Oh, I'm coming, I've just got one more flower for her.
Hubba Hubba in Hoobland, and Roma somewhere far away. The motorettes are singing.
Hoobmobile is coming your way.
Oh. Yay!